Well, and I think most everybody knows what are the benefits of early intervention, but would you quickly remind us, and then I'd love to just hear from you, what are some things you've personally witnessed from starting services earlier versus waiting if a parent's kind of on the fence?
Right. So it's always, you know, the earlier, the better. As soon as you have any communication or developmental concerns, I would reach out to early intervention and have them come in for an evaluation. I've seen that children who get early intervention services tend to have less frustration when it comes to communicating their wants and needs. So if we have a child who is struggling to communicate what they want, they start to develop, you know, these behaviors because they are so frustrated and can't get what they want. So for example, instead of being able to say or gesture a word, they will just throw themselves on the floor. And, you know, that's how mom or dad will really try to give them their attention and figure out what they want. And so if that type of behavior continues for an extended period of time, it's going to be harder for them to self-regulate and get out of that habit. So the earlier we can come in and intervene and provide strategies for the family and everyone around the child, then the earlier they can figure out what's the way to communicate with everyone around them rather than these frustrating habits that are going to happen. And there's also children who are late talkers and they just need that little push. And, you know, sometimes it seems like they catch up to their peers, but in the research, it says that, you know, if we don't catch these kids early, when they are tested, they still fall in the low average range. So we really want to be catching these kids early as soon as we see that there's a concern to just reach out. It can't hurt.
That's how I feel. I always said, it's not like we're saying, take this pill. You may, right. You may have these horrible side effects, but we'll see. Let's just take it. It's like, no, this would be beneficial for any child.
Exactly.
And especially one that's got a delay. And I'm curious, what are you seeing as far as, I know there was a period of time where it was sometimes pediatricians were, oh, let's just wait and see. Let's just wait and see. And then I felt like that improved and pediatricians were more likely to say, you know what, let's refer or help the family get set up earlier. What are you seeing in that front?
Right. It's kind of a mix. I think there are some pediatricians who are really great and they say, oh, just reach out to early intervention. So I've heard that, especially when I get my early intervention kids, when I get them early, like when they're, I don't know, 15 months, let's say 15 to 18 months. And I'm like, oh, this is great. You're reaching out early. And they'll say, oh yeah, my pediatrician just told us to get the evaluation. And then other kids, which I feel terrible when this happens, but they get to early intervention when they're, you know, 6 months, 5 months from aging out of early intervention. And they, you know, and there's a lot of parent guilt with that. And they'll say, well, my pediatrician told me to wait and see. And that's such a common thing that people say, and not just pediatricians. I think we all hear things from friends and family saying, oh, you know, so-and-so didn't talk until they were five and they're fine. They're totally fine. And then you hear those stories. And I think it's also coming from a place of fear from the parents. Maybe it's kind of like ignorance is bliss. They just want to wait and see and hope that the child will start to talk or communicate. So it's kind of a mixed review of pediatricians telling us to wait and see, or other pediatricians are more involved with the research and knowing that it's the earlier, the better.